I welcome you to my channel. In this video, I will discuss one chemical substance, acid. Till now, if you have not subscribed my channel, then subscribe it for getting the latest update. Then what is acid? Acid are those chemical substances which are sour in taste. Means, if you will taste the acid, it will give a sour taste. Suppose, see the example. Suppose you cut the lemon and you taste it, you get a sour taste. Why? Because of presence of acid. Tomato is sour taste. Why? Because of presence of acid. Curd is sour taste. Why? Because of presence of acid. Now acid are divided into two parts on the basis of occurrence. First one is mineral acid. The second one is organic acid. The acid which are prepared from the minerals are called mineral acid. Suppose the example, sulfuric acid, HCl, hydrochloric acid, nitric acid are three most common examples of mineral acid. Then organic acid, the acid which are prepared from the plants and the animals are known as organic acid. These are naturally occurring acids. Means if you taste the curd, you will get sour taste because of presence of lactic acid. Tomato is in sour taste because of presence of oxalic acid. On the basis of power, this acid is divided into two parts. First one is a strong acid and second one is weak acid. The acid which is completely ionized in water and produces a large amount of hydrogen ions is known as strong acid. Means if you will ionize the hydrochloric acid in the water, it will produce large amount of hydrogen ions. And weak acid, the acid which is partially ionized in water and produces a less amount of hydrogen ions are called weak acid. Now we will discuss the properties of acid. The first property already I have discussed that acid are sour in taste. Means if you taste the acid, it will give a sour taste. Second property is that acid turns blue litmus red. Means A, acid blue red. If you will drop the blue litmus solution to the acid, it will change the color into red. Third property is they are electrolyte. Means if you will acid solution, you will conduct electricity, the electricity will conduct. How? Because of presence of ions, they will conduct the electricity. Fourth property is that when metal react with acid, it forms salt and hydrogen gas. Whenever acid will be reacted with metal, then it will produce salt and hydrogen gas. See the example, suppose the metal is zinc and the acid is HCl. Here will be zinc chloride will be the salt and hydrogen gas will be evolved. You have seen? Then how you will see that hydrogen gas is evolved? When there will be pop sound made. Now comes to the fifth property. When acid react with base, it forms salt and water. Then this is also called neutralization reaction. Whenever acid or base will be react, it will form a salt and water. Suppose that take example. Sodium hydroxide is the base and HCl is the acid. The salt will be formed and sodium chloride and the water will be formed here. This is called neutralization reaction. Now come to the sixth property. Sixth property is that whenever acid heats reacted with metal carbonate, it gives salt plus carbon dioxide and water. Whenever acid will react with metal carbonate, there will be carbon dioxide gas will be formed. Suppose that take the example, sodium carbonate and acid will be hydrochloric acid. The salt will be formed here, sodium chloride. And carbon dioxide gas will be formed and H2O will be formed. Yeah, then how you will see the carbon dioxide gas is evolved? Whenever you will bring the burning candle near the test tube, the burning candle will be stopped. Now the seventh property is that if acid will be reacted with metal oxide, it will give salt and water. Also similar to neutralization reaction. Suppose that take the example copper oxide plus HCl, it will make H2O. When copper chloride has been formed, it is similar to the neutralizing reactions. If you have liked my video, then subscribe it, share it and comment it. Thanks for watching.